just off Lake Michigan, Soldier Field, here in Chicago, Illinois, the site for this matchup between the Seahawks and the Bears. You know, when you get a matchup at running back, like the one we have here today, you can just look down on the field from the booth, and you can see that breakaway speed and power with your own eyes, and there is a difference out there.
Yeah, I think I was always heard from Bill Walsh. I read it in his book, Trust Your Eyes. So you're right. We look down the field today, and as this thing goes along, you can tell we have two stars at running back, and, man, just give them a little bit of hope, and they can make it happen.
First down on the way. Hester's handed the football to the right side, and he's going to be tackled right around the 31-yard line.
That's a bread-and-butter play by all offenses in the NFL. Get a few yards and get that first down.
First and 10, back to the ground now on first down. And that's a gain of maybe 5.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line. It's really simple. Keep your eyes on the football. When they're not on it, that's when you drop it, and that's what happened that time.
Defense filling up the box here with a 4-6 formation. He's going to be swallowed up behind the line.
Good job that time by the defense. They get the fourth down situation here. They were bending a little bit, but they didn't give up the big play. Good job.
Forte lined up in the backfield. Throwing now to his left. Secures it with two hands.
What was the defense doing that time on that fourth down try by the offense? Disorganized, not ready, and they give it up.
First down here after the completion. Hester's got it on the handoff. And they advance the ball onto the other side of the field. So with that play, they move into enemy territory and driving here early stages.
Well, look, I'm going to blame the defense. They're being so passive. You've got to go out there and take some chances. If you don't, this offense is going to keep marching down the field.
Good job on the ground there by Matt Forte.
Good job by the running back on that long run. It's one thing to have talent, but the first thing you need as a running back is vision. You have to pick the right running lane. That's what he did that time, able to get down the field and get that long game.
Touchdown, Chicago Bears.
What a tremendous throw by the quarterback that time for the touchdown. What confidence he has in that arm. Small window, very little room to throw that football in there. He didn't worry about it, fired it, got the touchdown.
The Seahawks are set to return the kickoff. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. Harden's a receiver in the slot. First and 10, Marshawn Lynch takes the football.
Got to give the defense some credit on first down. There's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
Second down following the run. Halfway through this first quarter now. He's looking to the right here on this throw. Gains 19.
That was an awesome job that time by the quarterback getting out of the pocket. He keeps the play alive and able to throw it down the field for a nice completion.
Harmon's lined up in the slot. First and 10. Unable to bring it in. You don't see it often in today's game. These gloves these wide receivers wear, my gosh, anybody could catch it. I don't know how he dropped it.
Failing to complete that one. So, second down here.
Russell Wilson will take it from the gun. A foot race to the end zone.
The 10 inside, and he's home for the touchdown.
Nothing like it for a quarterback, I'll tell you that. I loved it. Throw a little short pass and just root your guy on and watch him score a touchdown. Pretty exciting stuff.
The Seahawks have erased the deficit and can tie it right here. Driving extra point is good. Seahawks ready here for the kickoff. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. Matt Forte lined up in the backfield, challenging the defenders to the right side.
Well, that was a nice throw by the quarterback that time to get just enough yards to pick up the first down.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down.
He'll fire it out to the left. Hester's got it on a pass that had some heat.
Gets it out to the 22.
Well, the quarter route. Some people call it the quarter route. They call it a flag, run to the flag of the end zone, or a seven route. Odd numbers break out. That time we see a nice route by the wide receiver and a good throw by the quarterback.
And here's the pass incomplete.
As much as these guys practice during the offseason, training camp, during the week, you think receivers and quarterbacks would always be on the same page. That time they were not, and it's another incomplete pass.
Snap back to the quarterback, out of the gun. He has the grab.
The old-fashioned way of picking up big yardage is running the fly route on the outside, show the speed of the receiver and the strength of the quarterback's arm. What a nice completion.
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up. And now they'll try over again on second down.
Looking to the right side and throwing. Has it. Touchdown.
Good job that time by the offense, scoring that touchdown and putting him ahead. And when you get ahead in a football game, the National Football League, it makes you relax and you play better.
The Seahawks are in shape now to return the kick. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. The Seahawks lined up in the pistol. Here's the handoff to Marshawn Lynch. And here he goes.
When you see long runs like that by a running back, a lot of things have to happen. Of course, he has good vision and he has talent. But how about those blocks down the field, those blocks in the secondary? That's what creates long runs.
Breaks the tackle.
The defensive end has the outside runs. That's his assignment, and he did it well. Takes on the tackle, beats his rear end up pretty good, and makes a tackle on the running back.
The Seahawks get a first down, and he's going to be tackled right around the 37.
The quarterbacks and receivers in this NFL now are so good. It's so easy for them to throw and catch and just keep picking up those first downs.
And as the first quarter comes to a close, we'll take a short break before the beginning of the second here in Chicago, Illinois. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
When you make play calls like that, you're not going to win many football games. That was a terrible call here on first down.
Second down and a long way to go. Got a flag. Penalty is declined. That last play will hold up. The Seahawks will tie it up with this extra point. It's good. Steven Hauschka ready for the kickoff. Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. From the gun. He's going deep. Incomplete, almost intercepted.
Well, for some reason, his quarterback likes to keep trying to go deep down the field against his cover two. That's not the spot you want to go. You want to look underneath or right down the middle.
That's second down coming up. Hester's taking the handoff. Right side, muscles through the defender. He's in the clear. He's in the clear. The 30 shifts away. And it's Earl Thomas who brought him down that time.
Nothing like seeing a complete offense. That's what we're watching here today. Yes, we know they can throw it, but what they're showing us here, they can grind out some first downs running the football too.
After picking up more than 60 yards on the previous play, and he's going to be brought down.
Well, you see it all the time. When the offensive line can't stop the defensive pass rush, then you have your running backs hit a defensive lineman before they go out for the pass.
From the shotgun. That ball is going the other way. He's brought down.
What a terrible job by the quarterback. Nobody's open. Tries to force the pass, and look, what's it turned into? An interception.
Harvin's lined up now as a slot receiver. It's handed to the running back. No one's going to get him now. He's at the 50. He's got some daylight. Good job on the ground there by Lynch.
A lot of ways to get plays in the NFL. It doesn't always have to be by a pass. Good job that time by the running back.
Here they come back to the line after the 50-yard gainer on the previous play.
When you're an offensive lineman and you can line up and just run the football straight ahead and pick up those kind of yards, you are going to get into the head of the defense. You're basically saying, we're tougher than you are, and we're just going to come right at you. The NFL is about situations. A good job by the runner knowing where the first down was, gets it there, and he moves those chains.
There are a lot of ways to attack cover, too. You could go deep down the middle where neither the safeties are, or if a linebacker covers somebody deep down the middle, then throw it short underneath the defense.
Takes in the slot. Second and 10. Escaping the pressure, looking for an open receiver on the right.
Nice throw that time by the quarterback in the red zone. Gets the completion. And there's some tight spots, not a lot of room, so you got to really drive the football in there.
Setting up in the pistol on this play. Makes the grab and picks up the first down.
Good play call that time by the offensive coordinator. down inside, when you're inside that 20-yard line or the red zone, find ways to complete the pass. They did that time. Hard to score a touchdown sometimes when you get in the red zone in the NFL. Why? Because the defense doesn't have to worry about passes down the field. The offense runs it. They are ready to get it done, and they do, and stop the offense for a short game.
Nickel formation for the defense here. Third and goal from the 5. Russell Wilson, touchdown, Seahawks.
Well, when your offense goes out there and scores a touchdown to put you ahead, it's got to give a big lift to the defense. They got to get excited and go out there and hold that lead.
The Bears are ready to return the kick. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. Hester's going to get set in the slot for this snap. Here's the handoff, and they'll run it. He's headed right.
What that run does, it just puts the offense in a good situation. So a good, positive run.
Big moment here for the defense. Lined up at the 46 defense. They'll run it. Here's the handoff. Taking off. This doesn't look good. We've got a player down, and he's in pain.
Well, that looks like an upper body injury, Jim. I think we both can tell that. And now the question is, how bad is it? You just never know.
That long game sets them up here on this play. Bennett's going to secure the handoff.
Running play went for 11.
And we've reached the two-minute warning in this one.
Nice job that time. The run play gets the first down. You move those chains. Hey, it's kind of fun to watch a team tough enough and patient enough to run the football to get these first downs instead of throwing it all the time.
Reaches out and grabs it. Into promised land. Touchdown.
There's no doubt about it. When you score like that to tie up the game, it shifts momentum. And it's all up now to the offense of the other team to get back out there and get the momentum back on their side.
Robbie Gould ready to kick it. And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line. Harmon's a receiver in the slot. First and 10. Lynch trying to plow ahead for about 5.
When you have a defense as fast as this one, they over-pursue. So that's why you want to run a counter run. Take advantage of the fact that they are just charging too fast, too hard, and not thinking on the defensive side.
Do one thing at a time. Catch the football. Then do the next thing, run with it. He tried to run with it too quick. That's why he dropped it.
Tate's lined up in the slot. Wilson from the shotgun. Running away from the pressure. Looking for Percy Harvin. The pass is off the mark, and that's a 3-and-out.
I think that's the hardest pass a defensive back has to defend. The long throws down the field. You have to wait till the last second to make your play. That time the defensive back did it. What a play.
Wilson's got it in the gun. Russell Wilson out to Sidney Rice.
Terrible game management that time by the coach. It's three downs. It's fourth down. What should you do? Well, I think you should punt it. He goes for it and puts his defense in a tough position.
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. Hester's going to take the handoff now.
Well, the play is there to be made, but the offensive player doesn't get it done. Bad job on first down.
They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second. And that's a big tackle behind the line of scrimmage. The Seahawks signal for a timeout. They have two remaining. The defense looking for one more stop here on third down after that run.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
Defense with plenty of bodies in the box here on this play. Zeroed in on that one.
You can't always go for it on fourth and short, but I like this call. They make it, the offense executes, and they pick up the first down.
This play set up by the long gainer. Takes the snap from the shotgun. The defense gets the sack.
Not a good job by the quarterback that time. Inside of 2 minutes in the first half, you got to get rid of the football. Nobody's open, just throw it away. That time, he loses yards by taking the sack.
Off the mark here as this throw heads out of bounds. Defense comes out in a 4-6 formation. Third down and 13. And he's almost intercepted.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work. And they stop the offense that time.
The quarterback coming to the line, hoping Chicago in the end zone.
This is why a head coach gets paid so much money. You get in situations like this, they have to make the call on fourth and goal. He goes for it, and they get it.
Count it. Bears ready to kick the football. Percy Harvin gets the chance to return this kickoff. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. Marshawn Lynch is in the backfield. First and 10. And he's taken down.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit here. You want to stop the offense and scoring here with under 2 minutes to go in the first half. Good pressure on the quarterback, and they take him down behind the line of scrimmage.
And with the second quarter coming to a close, we'll step away for halftime and return to the Windy City for the start of the second half after this. We're back here now in this one where the Bears are leading by 7. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. Harvin's lined up now as a slot receiver. Percy Harvin with the grab.
Good job by the quarterback completing that pass against the zone defense. Look for the open space when you throw against zones. That's what he did, and he got the nice completion.
Now on his way. He's at the 50, the 40, the 30. Lynch with an impressive run.
Anytime your team is down, you're inside the other team's red zone, you look for one of your star players, your quarterback, wide receiver, or running back. They need to make a big play here.
Lynch is called on once again. Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
That's a good job. He's able to get up and get off the field. And my guess is he's going to be okay. A little bit of a scare there, no doubt about it. That makes everybody nervous.
Harvin's in the slot. Second down, 14. Getting sacked.
Well, that's a good job by the defense at times, getting the sack on the blitz. And when you blitz, you're taking a chance. You better get to the quarterback, and that time they did.
Looks to his left. Golden Tate makes the catch. Plenty of zip on that throw.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third and long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
Intercepted.
Big enough to get in there and stop the run, and also athletic enough to be able to get in position and make an interception. Good job by the linebacker.
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. The Bears call timeout, and they'll have two remaining. Hester's going to get set in the slot for this snap.
The throw to the left. Could have been intercepted.
A lot of athleticism on display right there. Two battling for the football, and no one able to come away with it.
You said it right. Two tremendous athletes, but a good job by the defense that time. They won out.
Makes the catch.
Well, that's a nice completion by the offense. And what it does, it just puts them in a more manageable situation so they can pick up that third down.
Third and four. Hester's hand at the football. Picks up the first and still has some room to run. Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
Well, that's going to hurt him tomorrow. There's no doubt about it. When you get hit like that, you're going to feel some of that pain tomorrow. But the good news is, I think he's going to be okay. And once he gets a little situated there, I think he'll be back in the game. You might as well catch it because you're going to take the big hit no matter what. That time, the receiver lets the ball go because he was worried about the defender making the hit.
Second down after the incompletion. Throws to the right. Pass is made, and it's incomplete. The hit jars the ball out. Oh, we've got an injured player on the field.
In this game now, it's just so spread out. Everybody is so fast. You just can't avoid it. Concussions are just part of the game, and I hope he's okay.
And it's incomplete.
Anytime you get a chance as a defender in your own end zone to knock it down, that's what you do. Nice play by the defensive guy.
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. And a completion this time.
That's what you want to do. Get a first down while you're on top and keep that clock moving and just controlling the football game. Good job by the offense managing things so far here today.
Here's the first snap after the big play. The quarterback will hand it off. Going to be a tackle for a loss.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
Second and goal from the seven. He's looking to the right here on this throw. They're just grinding away down here, inching closer to the end zone.
Well, that's what you got to do sometimes. It's hard always to think that you're going to come out and just make big plays. You've got to do the dirty work, and this offense is doing it right now.
They've got them behind a line of scrimmage.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
Fourth down. It's now or never. And they'll turn it over on downs. The defense does a fantastic job holding strong. Harvin's a receiver in the slot. Makes the catch in open space. Tackle down right around the 48.
When you pick up first downs against the defense, they will get tired. That time, nice job by the offense getting the first down, even though they're losing here in the game.
Lynch is in the backfield, single back set. Looking across the middle, they pick up the first down with that reception.
Good job by the receiver that time. Getting that extra couple yards, gets a first down. They are marching. Let's see how the defense reacts.
Lined up in the pistol formation.
They go to the right side.
Unstoppable.
The 10, man in for the touchdown.
Well, here we are. It's a tie game now. We'll see how the teams react to it. Will it be positive or negative?
He made it. Seahawks ready here for the kickoff. And he's brought to the ground. Big set here for the defense, lining up in the 4-6. Now, makes the move to the right.
You got to keep your offensive linemen aggressive, so you have to run the football every once in a while. That run, even though it was a short game, it served a purpose.
There is a flag. Second down and 9. Going to lose yards here.
Offside. Defense.
The defender got caught in the neutral zone right there. That'll cost him 5.
Yeah, he's a little too anxious. You know, all these defenders, they got one thing in common. You know what that is? They hate quarterbacks. They want to get there. A little too nervous there. Gets him caught in the neutral zone.
Marshall's lined up in the slot. Second down, 4 to go. The handoff to Matt Forte has the first down. Now looking for more. Good job on the ground there by Matt Forte.
What a job by the offensive line that time. This running back hit the hole at full speed, and the defense had very little time to react. And that's how he got in the secondary, made a couple guys miss, and gets down there and gets a long run.
The wide receiver in motion.
First and 10. Matt Forte muscles through the defender. That'll put them in what we call plus territory.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Second and 4. They give it to the back, and he's running off tackle. He's tackled at the 28.
The off-tackle run, it's just what it says it is. You're going to read the tackle's block and decide whether you're going to go inside or outside. Usually, this is the first running play every team puts in their offense when they go to training camp.
They'll run with it again. They run right. Spins away from the tackle.
And for about 6.
Well, that was a nice run that time off-tackle. And listen, this is a bread-and-butter play in the NFL. It's about power running. Can your offensive tackle make the block to free up that running back so he has a chance to get in that secondary and make a nice run out of it?
15 minutes to go, and we'll return after this message and a word from your local station.
Hester's lined up now as a slot receiver. The final quarter underway now with this snap. Shrugs off the first hit.
Well, when you have a tie game and you're down in the red zone, you can do whatever you want. You can fool them with a run here, or you can take a chance and throw the football in the end zone to get a score.
Third and 1. Challenging the defenders to the right side. They have struggled on the third down, but not on that occasion.
Always a good job to pick up some yards when you're in the red zone. Nice throw by the quarterback, and he gets the completion.
The offense heads to the line for the 7th play of the drive. No margin for error from just outside the goal line. Left side. Powers his way across. Touchdown.
Ah, you just love it as a quarterback. You get down in there and it's first and goal. If you score, now you don't have to sweat the fact that, man, what are we going to do if it gets the third down? You don't have to worry about it. Good run. Nice touchdown.
Percy Harvin will be returning this one. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. Lynch is lined up directly behind the quarterback here.
sticks to his hands. They pounce on him there.
When you can't hit the quarterback or put pressure on him, there's not much you're going to get done then. That time, quarterback had time. He throws it down the field for another completion.
The Seahawks will go with the pistol on this play. They knock him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
Second down and 12. Russell Wilson has his man. It's Percy Harvin on the receiving end.
Nice throw that time by the quarterback in the red zone. Gets the completion. And there's some tight spots. Not a lot of room, so you got to really drive the football in there.
Oh, wow, another couple inches, and that would have been 6 points for the offense, but he just falls short.
That reception gave them the first down. They feed the running back. And he's in for the touchdown.
You got to give the offensive line just a lot of credit. It's first and goal. They just line up and power the football in there. Nice run, but a great job by the O-line.
Steven Hauschka ready for the kickoff. Got the hand up into the sky, and that means fair catch. The Bears come out in the pistol. First down and 10. Marshall's got it on the handoff. This doesn't look good. We've got a player down and he's in pain.
Always hard to guess what the injury is, but and don't like to speculate, but I think it's pretty apparent. It's an upper body injury. We'll let you know when we find out.
Defense filling up the box here with a 4-6 formation. A tackle behind the line.
Well, this defense all over that play. They tackle the runner for a loss. Now we're going to have third and long. Advantage goes to the defense.
Third down on the way. Looking to the right side and throwing. Right where it had to be.
How do you stop these receivers now? It's almost impossible with the rules of the game. Tight coverage. That time they have double coverage on him. It doesn't matter. The throw comes. They go up. They make the catch. All you can do is raise your arm and go, well, we did our best. Well, a short gain on the run that time by the offense. When you're a running football team, listen, there's going to be a lot of ugly plays that don't work. You just got to keep running it.
Matt Forte lined up in the backfield. Back to the running back. He's got some daylight. That's a gain of 7.
When you run off tackle, one of the things you're looking for is for your tackle to make a good block. And then if you have a lead fullback, can he get past him and block the linebacker to free up the halfback so he can go in between them and get in the secondary and make a big play? Boy, after watching that long run, I'm winded. That was a nice job by the running back. Good job up front, sustaining the blocks. Offense has got to be happy with that.
After the long gain, let's see what they do here. And he's tackled at the 32-yard line. Time becoming a factor in this game. Tight ends in motion here. Second down and 10. Right back to him one more time. That tackle was made at the 27-yard line.
Good job that time by the offense. Now a run gets him a few yards.
This will be the 8th play of this drive. And now we reach the 2-minute warning. Please. Let's see what they do on this third down situation.
The formation here, shotgun, under pressure and incomplete. The Seahawks defense lined up in a 4-6 formation.
Looking for an open receiver on the right and gets the first down.
When we were at practice on Friday, Jim, this team was working on red zone offense all the time. Well, here they are. It's a tie game. We'll see if all that practice pays off.
The long drive continues. The wide receiver shifting around in motion.
First and 10. Matt Forte gets it here. Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
So many things you can do on first down, and what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
Offense heading to the line for the 11th play of the drive.
Second and 11.
He gets it again on this drive. As he moves across the first down yardage and a new set of downs.
Can the defense make a stop? They bent a lot here in this drive. They had the offense backed up. They let him march down the field. Now you're in the red zone. Make the right call and stop him.
This will be the offense's 12th play of the drive. The Bears come to the line, fourth quarter, with two timeouts remaining. Takes a knee. The kicker, now with a chance to decide this game. The Bears, one timeout remaining.
Should be what we call a gimme.
The kick is through.
Well, it's a beautiful drive down the field. Long drive by the offense. They do not get the 7 points, but they're fortunate. They do get the field goal try, and they make it.
I'm sure it doesn't.